FC Unit 3 Concept of Disparity Part 2 Caste System. Caste system can be defined as a social structure according to class of people, which gets decided by their birth. The social stratification that categorizes people into different groups called caste. Caste system is a hereditary classification of people in a society. The status of a person gets predetermined in a caste system. No matter what you grow up to be, your birth caste does not change. Caste system is a hereditary phenomenon. Being hereditary, a person's caste is not under his control. It is something that is predetermined even before his or her birth. In ancient times, if you were born in a farmer's family, the society caste system dedicated you to grow up to be a farmer. The system is thus seen as a rigid one, where a person's choice and desire was restricted. Caste system was primarily meant to categorize the society on people's job specialization to prevent mixture between different segments of the society. Caste system divided the society into various segments. It aimed to group people of similar statuses together. There was a clear segmentation between the rich and the poor. For example, a sweeper, which belonged to the Shudra caste, was segmented as low caste according to the job description. The caste system preached inequality among people. People were categorized into high and low caste and treated differently in the society. The hierarchy of the caste was decided by the professional and family history. High caste people enjoyed every possible liberty. People from lower caste were treated miserably by the higher caste ones. Inequalities and the caste system. Following are the inequalities generated due to the caste system. First, lack of professional and business opportunities. Caste system did not allow exchange professions among different castes. As a result, a person born in a lower caste did not have any open professional opportunity. Also, there was no innovation in jobs. People just blindly inherited their professions. It kills the creativity in the professional and business. Second, child marriage. Caste system also encouraged child marriage. Due to child marriage, there are lesser chances of inter-caste marriage. Adults may stay away from the caste system rules and marry outside their caste. Thus, children were married before they could make a decision of their own. Third, threat to general peace and social stability. Caste system always threatened the peace and stability of the society. Inequality always gave rise to anger. Low caste people with suppressed right always look for chances to fight against the rules of the caste system. Fourth, inequality of economic conditions. The socio-economic conditions were unequal due to the practice of caste system. The wealth accumulated within the higher caste, whereas the lower caste were fated in endless poverty. Fifth, lack of freedom among people. Caste system had some serious effects on the freedom of people. All rules restricted people to practice everything intra-caste. Stepping outside your caste and socializing with people was not allowed. Sixth, opposite to democratic spirit. The caste system is opposite to the democratic spirit. Democracy promotes human equality, but the caste system believed in inequality. In caste system, there was a hierarchical arrangement wherein the Brahmins were at the top, whereas the Shudras were at the lowest. Seventh, low status to women. In the caste system, women were completely neglected. They enjoyed a very conservative and traditional type of status. They were denied the privilege of higher education. They could not voice their opinion in public affairs. Sometimes the lower caste women were sexually harassed by the higher caste males, but they could not protest against them due to prevailing social pattern. Hence, women enjoyed very low status in the caste system. Introduction of untouchability. The worst aspect of the caste system was untouchability. The untouchable suffered from various social, economic, political, and religious disabilities in the name of religion. They were thoroughly exploited in the most inhumane manner. The lower caste were placed in the category of untouchables. Their children were never allowed to be educated. They were forced to take unclean occupation. Ninth, false prestige among higher caste. Caste system created a false sense of prestige among the higher caste. The higher caste believed that they had the monopoly of wisdom. They felt that all other castes should consult them and work for them. This created a wide gap between the higher and the lower caste. 10th, hampered national development. For the national development, it is essential that all the sections of the society should contribute to the social welfare. But under the caste system, only higher caste people got the scope to contribute for the national development. Lower caste people were engaged in serving the higher caste, like the Brahmins and the Kshatriyas. Lower caste people did not have any choice in national development and advancement. Measures to solve casteism in India. First, increasing education. Education can abolish caste system. Through education, lower caste people can be educated about their democratic and moral rights. This helps them to know the effects of caste system. Women's education is also important to prevent them from getting exploited. Second, industrialization, especially in rural areas. To remove the caste system, it is important to increase the employment rate. Lower caste people face problem in getting job, especially in private sector. Industrialization in rural areas helps to generate job opportunities for lower caste people. This will increase unbiased job opportunities. Third, promote intercaste marriage among people. Intercaste marriage should be promoted among people. These marriages bring two families of different caste closer to each other. This way, the caste system problem can be solved. Fourth, role of media. Mass media plays important role in removing caste system. Mass media should be given the responsibility to develop a proper and broad outlook among people. Mass media can create awareness about the ill effects of traditional caste system. Fifth, improvement of judiciary and police. The judiciary and police force of India were unsuccessful in preventing caste discrimination. Measures should be taken to ensure that judges are not conservative or biased. Reservation in judiciary for lower caste will help a lot in this direction. The judges should be enlightened about the previous caste-based cases so that they can efficiently deal with the caste-based issues. Sixth, role of NGOs. The NGOs has a big role to play eradicating caste discrimination. They must put more pressure on the government for programs such as land reforms, primary education, the fight for equal opportunities and uniform legislation. NGOs can also create awareness about the problems and violence against Dalits which the media fails to address. They can also raise funds, provide employment and promote the importance of education among Dalits. 7th, protection by Constitution of India. Preamble of Indian Constitution promises to secure to all its citizens. Article 15 of the Constitution prohibits any kind of discrimination on grounds of caste, race, religion, gender or place of birth. Article 16 gives equality of opportunity in matter of public employment. Article 338 creates National Commission of Scheduled Castes to safeguard their interests, etc. 8th, social movements. Some social movements have also attacked the social system. The Brahmo Samaj movement led by Raja Ram Mohan Roy rejected the barriers of caste system and stood for brotherhood of man. The Prarthana Sabha movement supported by Justice Ranade brought about certain social reforms like intercaste marriage, remarriage of widows, etc. Communalism. Communalism arises among the society when a particular religious or sub-religious group tries to promote its own interest at the expense of others. In simple terms, it can be defined as to distinguish people on the basis of religion. Communalism is a dangerous ideology that promotes the false belief that one group, particularly one religious group, has more differences than similarities within outside groups. Famous communal violence in India. Partition of India, 1947. After partition, millions of population were forced to move from both sides of the border. Hindus in Pakistan and Muslims in India were killed in masses. Women were raped and many children lost their parents. There was hatred everywhere. Violence didn't see anything except bloodshed. Later, it turned into the problem of refugees and their rehabilitation became one of the biggest challenges for independent India. Anti-Sikh riots, 1984. This is one of the bloodshed in India where Sikhs in large numbers were massacred by anti-Sikh mob. The massacre took place in response to the assassination of Prime Minister Indira Gandhi by his own Sikh bodyguard in response to her actions authorizing the military operation. Ethnic cleansing of Kashmiri Hindu Pandits in 1989. Kashmir is known as the heaven of India, was known for its Kashmiriyat, that is, the reflection of love, peace, harmony through brotherhood and unity of Hindu, Muslims and other communities living together. But the brotherhood saw a serious blow due to extremist Islamic terrorism in the Kashmir Valley, which led to mass killing and large-scale exterminations of Kashmiri Pandits from the valley to the various regions and corners of India, giving them the status of refugee in their own country. Since then, the valley is under the grip of communal violence and the ongoing unrest has become a problem for the development of the people. Babri Masjid demolition in Ayodhya, 1992. According to Hindu mythology, Ayodhya is birthplace of Lord Rama and therefore it is sacred place for Hindu religion. But in medieval period, Mughal general Mir Baqi built a mosque named after Mughal ruler Babur. There were disputes since then and riots also took place. But in 1990, due to some political mobilization, there was atmosphere of protest by Hindu religious groups and in large scale Karsevak visited Ayodhya from all parts of India in support of demolishing Babri Masjid and building Ram Temple there. These movements caused huge amount of bloodshed and since then it is a disputed matter. After this violence was followed by the Godhra incident in 2002, when Karsevak returning from Ayodhya in a Sabarmati Express were killed by fire in the coaches of train. This act was followed by the extended communal violence in Gujarat. That violence is like black spot in the history of Gujarat and nation too. As people were killed without any mercy, Hindu and Muslim community became antagonists to each other. Till now, people are fighting for justice in Supreme Court with a ray hope from Indian judiciary. Assam communal violence 2012. Northeastern states are known for its distinguished tribal population and ethnic diversity and large scale Bangladeshi immigration has changed the demography of northeastern states, which often becomes reason for clashes. In 2012, there were ethnic clashes between Bodos and Muslims. Ethnic tensions between Bodos and Bengali-speaking Muslims escalated into a riot in Kokrajhar in July 2012, when unidentified miscreants killed four Bodo youths at Joypur. Muzaffarnagar violence 2013. The cause of this ethnic clash between Jat and Muslim community is very much disputed and has many versions. According to few, it was started after some suspicious post on social media platform Facebook. According to some, it was escalated after the eve teasing case in Shamli. Let the reasons be unknown, but what matters is the nature and scale of loss of the country with respect to human resource and peace. In all these and hundreds of other riots, one thing is common, that huge majority of victims have nothing to do with the communal hatred. In short, perpetrators of violence and victims of violence are different persons. Similar to above mentioned list, there are many more, which has impact on the masses and kill people on large scale. Bombay bomb incident 1993, attack of Akshardham in 2002 by Lashkar-e-Toyba and Varanasi bomb attack 2006 are few of them, having anti-Hindu outlook. Causes of communalism in India. First, past history. Immediately after independence, India was partitioned. The creation of Pakistan as a Muslim state gave rise to the idea of India as a Hindu state. In fact, a large number of Muslims and other religious communities continued to live in India even after 1947. After partition, millions of populations were forced to move from both sides of the border. Hindus in Pakistan and Muslims in India were killed in masses. Women were raped and many children lost their parents. However, unfortunately, many people in India belonging to various communities have failed to forget their past. Till today, problem of communalism is continued in India. Second, vote to communal leaders. In India, particular minority groups have always supported only those leaders who stand for their religion and community. Many times, people give vote to the candidate belong to their community. This leads to communalism in India. Third, presence of communal parties. Religion is an important factor in politics in India. It is also reflected in the ideology of a number of political parties. A number of communal political parties and organizations are present in India. Muslim League, Jamaat-e-Islami, Hindu Mashaba, Akali Dal, Vishwa Hindu Parishad are directly or indirectly responsible for communalism. Fourth, support from Hindu leaders. The Hindu religious groups like Shiv Sena, Hindu Mahasabha, Vishwa Hindu Parishad often pressurize the government to take steps suitable to the interest of Hindus. They consider each Muslim as pro-Pakistani and anti-national. To face the possible challenge of other communal forces, they encourage the growth of Hindu communalism. The controversy over the Ayodhya issue and the demolition of Babri Masjid was nothing but cause of communal riots in India. Fifth, poverty. Mass poverty and unemployment create a sense of frustration among the people. It generates backwardness, illiteracy, ignorance, etc. The unemployed youth of both the communities can be easily trapped by religious fundamentalists. The weak economic status often causes communalism. Sixth, isolation of Muslims. Indian Muslims have developed a tendency of isolationism even long after the creation of Pakistan. They remain remote from national politics. Most of them are not interested to take part in politics to the country. Muslims have distinct identity due to their different culture and customs. Their isolation creates a psychological separation and misunderstanding. It promotes communal tensions in the society. Seventh, cross-border factors. Communal tensions in India sometimes created due to our neighboring countries. These countries try to create communal problems in the border states. The communal problems of Punjab and Jammu Kashmir are caused due to provocation of Pakistan. So long as their cross-border factor is not removed, communal problems are likely to stay in India. Eighth, religion conversion. Another social cause of communalism is conversion. Every Indian has the right to follow whatever religion he or she likes. But when conversion from one religion to another is made by offering some facilities like money, education, service, etc., it creates problem of communal riots. Ninth, failure of government. Both the union and the state governments often fail to prevent communalism in the country. Due to lack of prior information, they fail to take any preventive measures, so the communal violence can easily take innocent lives and destroy property. The post-Kodha riot in Gujarat shows the inefficiency of the government to control the communal riot. Failure of immediate and effective steps has been a cause of the continuance of communalism. 10th, negative impact of mass media. The messages relating to communal tension or riot in any part of the country spread through the mass media. This results in further tension and riots between two rival religious groups. 11th, psychological causes. Psychological factors play an important role in the development of communalism. The Hindus think that the Muslims are fundamentalist. They also believe that Muslims are unpatriotic. On the contrary, the Muslims feel that they are being treated as second-rate citizens in India and their religious beliefs and practices are inferior. These feelings lead to the communal ill-feeling. Effects of consequences of communalism. First, communalism creates an atmosphere of intolerance and violence which would affect the flow of goods and capital. Second, the flow of labor from productive activities is diverted to unproductive activities. Third, there is massive destruction of public properties. Fourth, foreign investors would be more cautious to invest in country and not ready to take this risk of losing their investment. Fifth, law and order system is not in control. Sixth, molestation of women belonging to another community. Seventh, cause communal riots. 8th, destructing temples, forced conversions. 9th, demand for separate nation. 10th, it tries to weaken the economic structure of the country. 11th, it creates problem of refugees and their rehabilitation. Measures to resolve communalism. The following measures may be taken to resolve communalism. First, abolition of communal parties. All the political parties which support particular religion should be banned or abolished by the government. Even non-political organizations should be always be kept under constant observation so that they cannot preach communalism. Second, transmission of the past heritage. Feelings of nationalism should be inculcated in the minds of people. People should remind about the moments of history in which Hindus, Muslims and Sikhs were combined to safeguard the interest of the country. Third, public opinion. Efforts should be made through mass media for changing the attitude of people towards other communities. People must be aware of the effects of communalism. Fourth, interreligious marriage. Youth organization and other types of association should be formed in every locality to give opportunity to people of different communities to come closer and know each other. This may help them to practice interreligious marriages, which will reduce the social distance among the members of different religious groups. Fifth, spread message of brotherhood. Proper use of mass media, both print and electronic, should be made. Media should spread the message of religious tolerance and common brotherhood in case there is a communal riot. The victim should not be identified either as Hindu, Muslims or Sikhs. Sixth, role of election commission. Election commission should impose ban on all communal organization and communal political parties. The election commission should prohibit all sorts of political campaign on communal line. Political parties should have a code of conduct not to involve in any anti-communal activities. 7th, peace and brotherhood committees. Government should form peace and brotherhood committees at local levels to ensure healthy atmosphere. This committee should prevent the anti-social elements who involve themselves in communal riots. 8th, promote national integration. Measures must be taken to promote national integration, like joint celebration of the community festivals, observation of restraint by the Hindus in taking out processions before the mosque, and in Muslims' localities cultivating a sense of respect of religious beliefs, etc. Youth leadership and training program. Various schemes like NCC, NSS, Girls Guide, Scout, youth leadership and training program should be promoted. Educational tools and exchange program should also be used for creating healthy temperament among the youth. 10th, remove poverty. Since poverty encourages the forces of communalism, all efforts should be taken for the economic development of the people. 11th, socialization of children. Communalism is a psychological disorder or mental problem. For the removal of the communal hatred, proper socialization of children is necessary. Common living and common share of life should be encouraged by the families, schools, social activists, etc. The educational system must be designed systematically for checking communalism. For this purpose, special books, booklets, pamphlets, articles should be published to do the needful in this direction. Regionalism in India. Regionalism is a feeling of loyalty to a particular part of a country. It is a strong feeling of pride or loyalty that people have for a particular region. Regionalism means the strong feeling of people in favor of the local area in which they live. A vast country like India naturally faces the problem of regional identities. India is a large country having continental dimensions and comprising 28 states and 7 union territories. It is a multiracial, multilingual nation. Therefore, diversity of regional languages, regional culture among people is very common. Regionalism need to be regarded as an unhealthy or anti-national phenomenon if the people of a region have a genuine pride in their language and culture. To certain reasonable limit, this regionalism is considered tolerable. It helps the people to take initiative for all the round progress of the local areas, but many a times this extreme regionalism harms national unity and interest. Locally centered emotional attachment must be conducive to overall national growth. Examples of regionalism in India. Shiv Sena against Kannadigans. In 1966, Shiv Sena in Maharashtra launched its agitation against Kannada geese in the name of Maratha pride. The first target of its agitation were some South Indians who were the workers of Udupi hotels in Mumbai. This agitation was labeled to be a retaliation of the lathi charge on Marathi-speaking people in the border areas. Khalistan movement. It was during the era of 1980s, the Khalistan movement, with its aim to create a Sikh homeland, often called Khalistan, cropped up into the Punjab region of India and Pakistan. In fact, this demand has also the colors of communalism, as they demanded is only for Sikhs. MNS target North Indians. It was in 2008, Maharashtra Nav Nirvan Sena, MNS, workers began their violent agitation against North Indians. Bhojpuri films were not allowed to run on theatres in Maharashtra. The targets were vendors and shopkeepers from North India in various parts of Maharashtra. Interstate disputes. Another form of regionalism in India has found expression in the form of interstate disputes. There are disputes, boundary disputes, for example, between Karnataka and Maharashtra on Belgaum, where Marathi-speaking population is surrounded by Kannada-speaking people, between Kerala and Karnataka on Kasargod, between Assam and Nagaland on Rengma Reserve Forest. There is a dispute over Chandigarh in Punjab and Haryana. Causes of regionalism. First, unbalanced regional development. In the present times, uneven developments in different parts of the country may be the prime reason for regionalism and separatism. There are certain regions in the country where industries and factories have been concentrated, educational and health facilities are sufficiently provided, communication network has been developed, rapid agriculture development has been made possible. But there are also certain areas where the worth of independence is yet to be realized in terms of socio-economic development. This disparity has caused the feeling of relative deprivation among the people of economically neglected regions. Second, political administrative factors. Political parties, especially the regional political parties, as well as local leaders, exploit the regional sentiments. They give place to the regional problems in their election policy and promise for political and regional development. In the present day Indian political scenario, some regional parties have strongly emerged and captured power in some states like Telugu Desam in Andhra Pradesh, Assam Gana Parishad in Assam, Akali Dal in Punjab, Jharkhand Party in Bihar, etc., have posed constant threat to the nation. Third, make Hindi as national language. Firstly, the efforts of central government after independence to make Hindi the national language led to the widespread agitation and led to the rise of regionalism. The southern states thought this was a major step by the center to impose its will on them. People who opposed this idea went on to cultivate an endless superior feeling towards their own mother tongue or regional languages. This was done in order to preserve their culture, but later continued on to become a political one. Fourth, desire for regional independence. The desire of the regional parties to have a greater independence over their own region and to improve the living conditions to their own people leads to regionalism. Fifth, negligence from state government. The continuous neglect of people belonging to certain region within a state and not allowing them to participate in the activities of politics, using their resources without concerning them, etc., led to feeling of regionalism. This gives birth to the concept called son of soil. Effects of regionalism. First, regionalism makes people narrow-minded to think only about their religion, and they do not accept people of their region and culture. It develops a superiority complex in the minds of people who have inhabited a place for many years and gives them a false sense of ownership over the region. Regionalism adversely affects on national integration. Fourth, regionalism leads to the formation of multiple communities within one nation and restricts the free interaction of culture and traditions between a country's citizens. Fifth, regionalism has been used for political leverage in order to secure a vote bank. Sixth, demand for reservations to local language speaking person increased for employment. Seventh, regionalism leads to demand for separate state. Measures to resolve regionalism in India. First, balanced distribution of national resources. Regional imbalance has been the main cause of dissatisfaction among the people of a particular region for regionalism. If the national resources are distributed in a balanced manner, the problem of regionalism will be mitigated. Second, abolition of regional parties. The regional parties play a dirty role in exploiting the regional feelings of people. Therefore, efforts should be made to ban all regional parties posing threat to national unity. Third, development of backward regions. Due to uneven development of different areas of the country, political issues have been made. For example, the issues of Telangana in Andhra Pradesh and Vidarbha in Maharashtra. It increases enmity between different regions. Therefore, top priority is given to the economic development of backward regions. Fourth, developed means of transport and communication. Most of the backward regions of the country do not have proper link with the rest of the country through the transport and communication system. Due to this reason, their interaction and contact with other regional groups become restricted and they develop a feeling of isolation. Therefore, transport and communication system should be developed in the backward areas in order to bring economic and social development. Fifth, proper education. The Indians as a people have great respect and love for education. Since their appearance is authentic history, they have enjoyed the reputation of being learned people. Therefore, education may be a very powerful agent for removing regionalism and for developing the sense of nationalistic spirit among the people. Sixth, appeal through the mass media. Today, mass media have become very powerful agents of change. If both direct and indirect appeals are made, highlighting the concept of equality of opportunity to every region for their development and the concept of national unity through various programs like Mera Bharat Mahan, people will be motivated to cut across regional boundaries and come forward for national development. Linguism in India. India has become a land of many tongues and has been called as a tower of veritable languages or a museum of languages. In 1950, the states in India were reorganized on linguistic basis. As a result, the domiciles of a particular state speak a particular language. The Constitution of India has approved of 22 languages. The Constitution of India designates the official language of the government of India as Hindi, written in the Devanagari script, as well as English. There is no national language as declared by the Constitution of India. Hindi and English are used for official purposes such as parliamentary proceedings, judiciary, communications between the central government and the state government. States within India have the liberty and powers to specify their own official language through legislation, and therefore there are 22 officially recognized languages in India. At present, the language problem has become so sensitive that it has posed a major threat to national integration. Most often, linguistic tensions are being manifested in the borders, which are bilingual. For example, in Belgaum, there is a tug of war between Marathi and Kannada-speaking people. Assam confronted with Bengali and Assamese. Although Hindi has been recognized as the national language, this has promoted bitter hostile, and particularly in the south. Causes of linguism. Some of the important causes of linguism are discussed below. First, love of literature. Love of literature creates and strengthens a sense of loyalty towards it among the linguistic groups. These linguistic loyalties hamper the progress of a common language. Second, geographical causes. Geographical conditions also promote linguism. People living in a particular locality tend to speak the same language. This promotes local identity and distinctiveness among people. Living together geographically reinforces a linguistic group's love for its own language. Third, historical causes. Linguism in India is a byproduct of India's struggle for national freedom. Our leaders of freedom movement criticized the British system of dividing country by cutting across. Rather, they pleaded for the division of India into different provinces along linguistic lines. After independence in 1956, the states were reorganized on the basis of homogeneity of language. The reorganization of the states of the linguistic lines was provided geographical foundations for sub-nationalism in India. Fourth, political causes. Narrow-minded political parties create linguistic feeling among the people of a locality and exploit their sentiments at the time of election. Fifth, psychological causes. Language has certain psychological and emotional characteristics which raise the feeling of ecocentrism to a homogeneous group. In India, the linguistic groups are tied together by ties of common interests. This creates the spirit of regionalism, scatteranism, and separatist feeling in the mind of citizen. Consequences of linguism. The evils of linguism are as follows. First, increasing regionalism. The people of different linguistic groups who are concentrated in a state seem to think only in terms of interest of their own states. This undermines consideration of national issues and causes narrow-minded feelings. Second, formation of regional political parties. Linguism has resulted in regionalism, which has ultimately led to the formation of regional political parties in some state. Some of these regional political parties have also formed government. Such political parties in power often complicate center-state relationship. Third, harassment of the linguistic minorities. The State Reorganization Commission had proved for safeguard of linguistic minorities in states. But in reality, the linguistic minorities have been harassed in different states. As a result, certain complications and disturbing trends have developed which seem to have threatened the unity of the country. Fourth, demand for separate states. Linguistic conflict take place due to selfish motive of politicians. These politicians promote the linguistic minority to demand partition of the state along the linguistic lines. The demand for a separate state creates problems for the concerned state as well as the center. Fifth, erosion of national feeling. The national feeling is eroded due to linguistic and regional loyalties. The erosion of national feeling threatens the sovereignty of the country. Sixth, interstate border dispute. Language problems have created tensions in the border which are bilingual. For example, the Goans are divided on the basis of Konkani and Marathi languages. Remedial measures. Following measures have been taken for the eradication of tensions between different linguistic groups. First, development of a national language. Although Hindi has been recognized as the national language, it has caused bitter hostilities, particularly in the south. It will be unwise to impose Hindi on non-Hindi speaking people. Therefore, the spread of Hindi as the national language requires most care and tact. Second, development of common script. At present, there are a number of scripts in India, but if a common script is evolved, it would break through the script barrier which separates one language area from another. M.N. Srinivas' suggestions for the use of Roman script may also have been considered. Third, ban on political parties and other organizations. The regional political or any other organization which tries to exploit the sentiments of people along the linguistic lines should be banned. 9. The Sarkaria Commission was appointed in 1983 to examine the language problem in India. The commission made a couple of recommendations for the solution of the problem. It suggested that the styles, forms and expression of English along with other regional languages are to be retained in the process of development of official language. The three language formula such as regional language, Hindi and English should be properly implemented.